Welcome to the second part of the Magic Forest tutorial. No magic forest can exist without magic mushrooms like these, but you can see that don't look very magic. So in this tutorial, we're going to show you how to make them a little bit more magic. So let's get started. So let's pick our stuff. I'm going to need the developer tooltip, also the light tooltip and the material gun and our light source. So let's place it here. And let's go over there to the mushrooms. So this looks like a good spot. Let's place the light here so we can see a little bit better. So we want to create a nice glowing material for the mushrooms. So let's select the developer tooltip. Let's create new material, PBS metallic. And let's set this material up as emissive. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to drag the albedo color to a very dark one. So it's not reflecting a lot of light. The next thing, I'm going to set the emissive color from black. Let's say red. And let's give it a little bit of a white color. So you can see it is already glowing, but it's not bright enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this slider to give it a little bit of gain, which gives it this nice bright glow. So let's tweak this material a little bit more. Let's make it smooth. Can tweak the color a little bit more. So you can see this has nice combination. It has still some shine to it, but it also has this bright outer glow. So I'm pretty happy with this material. I would like to make it VR theme, so I'm going to make another. So let's grab this one and let's select duplicate. And the inspector is still open for the other material, so let's change the hue to another color. And we are going to go for the cyan, like the stereoscopic anaglyph glasses. Let's do this first. If I apply the material, you can see they get this nice glow. But if you move the flashlight out of the way, you can see they have this nice glow, but they don't illuminate the environment. And that is because emissive materials don't actually emit light, they only look that way. So to actually make them illuminate the environment, we are going to use a light source. So I'm going to use the light orbit. And let's change the color to red. And now if I place a light source in the mushroom and drag a little bit, you can see it starts illuminating the environment. So now if we move further back and remove the flashlight, so if the color isn't completely to your liking, you can simply drag the light sources out of it and try anew. So we have removed all other light sources. So you can see it is pretty dark. And I'm going to try anew and make them a little bit more supple. So you can see this is looking pretty good. It's actually illuminating the tree a little bit, giving it a little bit of an ominous look. So we are going to do the other mushrooms in a similar way. So I'm also going to duplicate the light orbit. So my colleague has one as well. So there you go. And you need to adjust it to the same color as your material.
Approximately, right?
So now we have everything ready. I have my light tooltip. I have my material gun. And my colleague has the same for the other color. So now we can go find some mushrooms and make the magic. So let me take my flashlight. Oh, there's some mushrooms behind you. Maybe you can do these ones. And there's some more. I saw some more over here. Somewhere. Oh, there is some more. There's actually two. So maybe you can do these ones, and I'm going to do these.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is actually quite nice looking. So looks like there's pretty much all the mushrooms in this forest, so we hope that we didn't forget any. However, there is still one crucial component missing in our magic mushrooms, and that's magic spores. And for that, we are going to use the particle system. So let's go over here. So let's grab the developer tooltip, and let's create a new object. We are going to start with an empty object and select it using inspector. And we are going to set it up as a particle system. So let's attach a new component. And in rendering, there's particle system and particle system. This component takes care of the simulation of the particles. However, it needs more components, and that is particle style. So let's attach it as well. So there is particle style. This component essentially defines what the particles will look like. And we need to set a reference for the particle system. So let's grab it and drop it over here. And we also need something to actually emit the particles. So let's attach it another component. And in rendering, particle system emitters. You can see there are several different shapes you can use for emission. We are going to use sphere emitter. So let's attach this. The sphere emitter needs to know the particle system it needs to emit the particles for. So let's set the reference as well. We still can't see anything because the rate is set to zero. So let's set some value. So let's set some non-zero value, for example, 10. And you can see it is emitting particles. However, they don't have any material, so they look this weird pink, but it's a good start. So next, we need to give the particles some nice material. So let's attach another component. And in assets, we are going to use analyze material. And if you look at the particle style, you can see that it does a material reference. So let's drop it over. And you can see it starts using some material. So let's tweak it a little bit. Let's make it use additive blending, which gives them this nice glow. So you can see they are using default white color. We could either set a color tint in the material. However, if you look at the particle style, you can see there's two properties called max color and the min start color. So we can use these properties to actually give each particle a unique color. So let's set the min start color to red. And now we can see each particle is a random blend between white and red. So let's take it a little bit more. They also have no texture, so we would like to assign one. You can either import the texture from your hard drive or you can find it in NEOS. We have actually prepared an experience for you where there is a bunch of sprites that you can use for particle system and brushes. So let me go to the Content Hub. And here on the right, you can find tutorials and resources. And if I go over there, there's an experience called Particle Brushes. So let's go in there. And in this experience, you can find a bunch of sprites. So let's take a look. And you can see there's a bunch of different sprites that I could use. And I really like this glowing disk, so I'm simply going to take it. And while I'm holding it, I'm going to switch back to the Magic Forest. And here I have the sprite. So now I simply grab it, I scroll over to the unlit material, and I will drop it as the texture. And you can see now they have nice disk shape. So you can see it's starting to shape up. So another thing is that the particles are way too fast. There is another set of properties called min start speed and max start speed. So let's decrease it a little bit. So let's try, for example, 0.1 to 0.2. And you can see the particles are much slower, although they are starting to bunch up a little bit. Also, their size is too large, so let's decrease that as well. So there is min start size and max start size. So let's try 0.1 for the minimum size and 0.2 for the maximum size. Actually, it could be a little bit bigger, so let's try 0.3. So this is looking much better. We would also like the particles to start flowing up from the mushrooms. So if we go to the sphere emitter, you can see there's a force direction. So let's enable it. You can see the vector is currently zero, so they don't have any initial direction. And let's set it along the y-axis, which is upwards. And we can see the particles start to rise. You can also see the emission starts from a very small area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the sphere emitter size. So let's try, for example, 0.4. This is maybe too much, so let's try 0.3. And this is looking pretty good. You can actually use the developer tooltip to move this particle system over to the mushroom so we can see what it looks like in place. So when it is in place, you can see that we can actually increase the radius a little bit more. So let's try 0.5. So this is pretty nice looking particle system. So another thing, I would also like the particles to rise a little bit higher. So what I need to do is I can either increase the speed, but I like the speed. So I can give them a longer lifetime. You can see there is minimum start lifetime and maximum start lifetime. So I'm going to increase that a little bit. Let's try doubling it, for example, from 5 to 10. And now if you wait a little bit, you can see the particles live a lot longer. You can also change the rate a little bit. For example, you can see we set it to 10. If I increase it, this will make a lot more particles, but this is not looking too good. You can also decrease it to make fewer particles. But I think I initially struck a good balance, so let's set it back to 10. So this is the particle system pretty much finished. So now we need to apply it to the other mushrooms in the forest. However, to make it a little bit easier to manipulate, you can see that I can now only interact using the developer tooltip. I'm going to attach another component, that is a collider. So I go to the physics, collider, sphere collider. And if I go here, I can set it to something small, so it's not interfering too much. And I also attach another component. So that is a transform interaction slider. It essentially allows me to grab the particle system and move it around and also duplicate it. Let's actually deselect it. And now if I reach over here where the collider should be, I should be able to move it around. And you can see now the particles rise from here. So if I select duplicate, I can make another copy and place it back here. And I'm going to tweak this copy. So I have one for the silent mushroom. So let's change this. Oh, so you can see I actually placed the modified copy here. So let's take this one, and you can see they are already cyan, so I can tweak the color a little bit more, and let's give it a little bit of a gain. And I'm going to grab this one, and create another duplicate, and let's place it here. And I'm going to give this one to my colleague, so let's find the collider, it should be around here. So it is a little bit strange, because we are moving sort of invisible object, but if you use your laser, you can actually find the collider. So that could help you if in case you can't find it. So we are now going to duplicate the particle system and place a copy for each set of mushrooms. So my colleague will do the cyan ones again, and I'm going to do the red ones. So let us start. So there's some mushrooms here. So let's place it here. And I'm also going to create a duplicate, so I can do another. Oh, I see my colleague already set up this one. So it looks like there's all of the mushrooms, because there's not that many of them. So I still have one copy, but I don't need it anymore. So I'm going to select delete, and let's delete this one. And my colleague will do the same. So there we go. You can now see that our magic forest also has some nice magic mushrooms, with magic spores. So thank you very much for watching. So this is another part of our magic forest done. So in the next tutorial, we are going to show you how to make a flaming torch, which is a lot more fitting for this environment. So anyone who visits this world doesn't have to explore it in darkness. So see you next time.